Ryan, welcome. I think that we can have a go. First of all, thanks all for being here. My name is Dr. Brandoni. I am the course director of the MSc Energy Storage. We are going to look at the key information about the course, and please feel free to ask me questions. You can do by the end of the session. Unmuting your microphone, or you can just write and type your questions on the chat box, and then I will, at the end of the session, I will answer to all your questions. Now, let's come to the MSc Energy Storage. First of all, before discussing the details of the course, I would like to give you a brief introduction of the benefits of studying at Ulster University. First of all, there is an excellent conversion, excellent range of conversion courses if you want really to change your career. I know that some of you, because you have already contacted me, come from a different background and you would like to focus more on energy related subject and in particular on energy storage technologies. For sure, you will get a competitive edge in employment. Attending a MSc Energy Storage and achieving your degree will give you for sure personal fulfillment. Our course is taught by experts, by people that do research in the field of energy storage technologies, and this is a very great advantage. You will be supported by a study environment. And our course is now on the pathway to achieve the accreditation from the Energy Institute. It is a new course, so it will take still another couple of years before getting the accreditation. And definitely, since we are working in the research field and we have great links with industry bodies and employers that will be available for you once you join our course. Now, if we look at why doing a postgraduate, there are some benefits that can be quantified. First of all, it seems that students who have a postgraduate can have £7,000 extra average amount of earning. There is a 21% higher possibility to be employed in a high skill employment. There is, as we mentioned, increased earning, and that was also has been mentioned by the Department of Education. And here you can look at all the sources and look by yourself to see what will be your real advantages once you will get the degree from a postgraduate study. Our course will be face to face. However, I would say that it is extremely flexible. We are working with the Blackboard environment, so all the material is online. The course will be taught the full time in 2 days, the part time 1 day. So if you're working, you can still, with the part time course, attend, do your work, and then be able to attend and get the qualification from a postgraduate course. We work really with the broad range of industry networks to include professional accreditations wherever it's possible. And as I mentioned, there is this possibility with the MSc Energy Storage. If you want to apply to UU, please, you need to do online. And this is through our website. On the 16th last week, it was recorded the webinar about how to do this admission, and you will find in the YouTube page. So please connect to the video, and you will get also additional information. However, if you need any, if you have any issues, always send drop me an email because I can try to help and see to contact admission and help you if you are struggling in submitting your application. In terms of fees and finance, I think that it is pretty interesting to know. The courses start from £6,270. If you have been a student at UU, you will have a 10% discount, and there is the possibility to get a loan up to £5,500 and 5% discount for upfront payment. Again, all this information can be found in more details in our website. Now, let's come to the content of the MSc Energy Storage. Why do you think it's important to study energy storage? And I would like to give you an overview of the real need of this topic in our energy market. If you think about climate change, we know that renewable energy is a key climate solution that can provide a big reduction in carbon dioxide emissions and in the reduction to in reducing our dependence on fossil fuels. But there are some renewable sources like wind and solar that are not easy to operate because they are intermittent and difficult to predict. So, in order to exploit those resources as much as possible, you will need to think to energy storage technologies. If you look at the policy of both developed, but I would say also developing country, maybe it is even more interesting for them. The renewable energy growth is really at the top of any agenda. And the decarbonization of the energy sector will have to be in different fields, in the electricity field, thermal field, and transport sector. But in order to achieve, in order to exploit all the renewables, you will have to introduce energy storage technologies, and it is what is going to be done within this course. If you look at the market demand for energy storage technologies, according to the New Energy Outlook 2019, there was a prediction, a forecast for a growth in the energy storage market of 250 billion by 2040. And all the main players that are working with renewable technologies are now also looking at energy storage technologies. If we think about renewable energy capacity, what is expected is a 12 terawatt expansion of generating capacity. That means 13.3 trillion of dollar, and 77% of this amount of money will go to renewables. So for this reason, I think there is market, there will be jobs available, and let's now come to think, what are you going to do if you attend the energy course after your successful completion? Generally, graduates are more employable, in particular in energy transmission companies, energy distribution companies, energy supply companies, consultancies, both at regional and national government level. One of my students that is now working on her dissertation, and she's going to finish the MSc in this winter. She will graduate this winter. The submission of the dissertation is in the first days of September. She will start then to work for Sony. And now Sony has also a base in Belfast, but the main headquarters is in Dublin. So that means that there is a huge interest in such expertise. You can also choose, after the completion of a postgraduate, to pursue a career as an academic or a researcher career. And I believe that our Center for Sustainable Technology, that is linked to the MSc Energy Storage, is the right place to be. As I mentioned from the start, the course is a research-led course. It means that all the lecturers are active in researching in the area of renewable sources and energy storage technologies. Here are some of the area where you're working on, from solar energy, bioenergy, heat pumps research. There is a huge research in the area. Our head of school is really one of the key international players for the pump research, energy storage, energy modeling, low carbon retrofit, advanced glazing. We're also looking at water and energy nexus. So all those areas are areas that are covered by the lectures that you will have in your course. And I think that you will strongly benefit from that. Now let's come to the subject that you will find and how the course works. First of all, now let's come with this. If the start is in September 2021, you will attend in the first semester for a full-time course for subject. There will be an overview of the current status of energy systems, because in order to understand how you will change the current system, to how you will decarbonize the current system, you need to know what are the current technologies that are used for producing heat, electricity, and for the transport sector. Then you will have a focus on the two key intermittent and renewable technologies that needs to have energy storage in order to be fully exploited. So you will have a module dedicated to wind energy conversion technologies and the module dedicated to solar energy processes and technologies. Always in the same semester, in the first semester, you will work on thermal storage and heat networks. As I mentioned to you from the very beginning, it's not a matter of only of the electricity sector, because sometimes when we hear about the use of renewable, we immediately think about electricity. But in order to decarbonize the energy system, we will have to decarbonize both the heat and transport sector. All these modules are 15 credits. You don't have exam, but you will have to submit courseworks. You can have a maximum of 2 pieces of coursework for each module. We try as much as possible to dilute the submission of, in terms of deadline, the submission of the coursework. But generally, I would say that they are concentrated as normal at the end of the semester. The second semester that will start in January, you will start to work on the energy policy, market and economics, because when you think about energy storage technologies, you will think that you will study about energy integration. So you will study how to overcome the current barriers in terms of markets, in terms of infrastructure, to allow a larger deployment of renewable energy technology in order to arrive to this net zero energy system. You will then focus on the electricity storage and the electricity network, on distributed energy resources, and you will have a module I'm going to teach you in this module about the international best practice in energy storage integration. What we are going to do in this module, it's pretty practical. We are going to use a tool, a model that is available on the web. It is called Energy Plan, and we're going to understand in a bit more detail, and by developing ourselves a model on an entire country, what it means to go toward a net zero carbon. If we increase the amount of renewables in terms of wind, intermittent renewables in terms of wind and solar, what are going to be the problems, and what are the best energy storage technologies that we can integrate? And during the module, you will learn about what works in other countries. For example, California is at the forefront, and you will learn from the best practices. Again, all the modules on the second semester are coursework based. There are no exam, but you will have to work quite a lot in the developing your coursework. In the third semester, there is the dissertation. The dissertation is 60 credit points. What I would like to highlight is that after the successful completion of all modules and of the dissertation, you will be able to achieve the MSc award. However, if for any reason you want to stop after the first semester, you will be able to immediately get the postgraduate certificate exit award. And after the second semester, you will be able to get the postgraduate diploma exit award, also if you're not going to complete the research dissertation. You have the possibility to start the MSc in January, but in this case, since you cannot do the dissertation before the completion of the two semesters, what will happen is that you're going in January to start with the second semester. You will have a break in this case during the summer. You will then attend the first semester the following September, and in the next year you are going to cover your dissertation. So in this case you will graduate in the summer of 2023. Okay, it is 18 months length if you will start in January. In addition to the full time, there is the opportunity to attend the course part time. What change is that, okay, first of all, you have 3 years. Each year you cover 4 modules, and each semester you have 2 modules to address, as you can see from the slide. And the third year is dedicated to the research dissertation. The modules are the same. The positive is that, as I mentioned you, the teaching is concentrated in one day. So that allows you to work and also to have time to work on the module and the delivery of the coursework to pass the module. Now, our environment, all our teaching material is on Blackboard. You will need to be familiar with Blackboard. Maybe some of you have already attended the Astro University course. So some of you are coming from the BC Energy, some of you are coming from other courses, so you are aware of the environment. But for the ones that are new, don't worry. There are tutorials, and you will find for each module in Blackboard all the materials, all the teaching materials, the recording of the lesson, whatever you need. There is a common area. This common area is the program support area where you can find additional information. In terms of regulation, each module, in order to be passed, need 50% of the score. The progress from semester 1 to semester 2 is automatic. And failure up to 60 credit points, it means if you fail all the first semester, you have still opportunity to have a summer seat. But when you fail 90 credits, you need to repeat the year, and over 90 credits, you will be withdrawn from the course. I'm sure it will not be your case, but just to be clear, what are the regulations? There is a pass that is 50%. You will pass with commendation for a 60%, and you will pass with distinction with an average of 70% of all the module. Remember that the dissertation covered the 60 credit point and not 15, like all the other modules. So in order to get a 70 for as your pass, you will need also to get a mark of 17 for your dissertation. The weighting of each module's contribution to the final result will be determined by the module's credit value, but you can quickly do your maths because each module 15, apart from the dissertation, that is 60 credit points. Now, the first semester will be delivered in Jordanstown, as you have been notified. And if rules are not changing, it seems that we will have finally coming back to the campus, although with COVID-19, don't worry, because there will be all the health and safety issues in place. After the semester, we will move to the new Belfast campus. However, if you want to access the campus, to work in the campus, to access the library, it will be open from September 2021. But in terms of teaching, the classes will be in Jordanstown for this semester, and the next semester will be in Belfast. But you can go to Belfast to study and to enjoy the new campus in the city center. Now, to have all the information about updates about the coronavirus, you can keep you up to date. Visiting the Aster webpage, aster.ac.uk/coronavirus. We aim to attend face to face, but if there will be any issues, you will be informed on time. And as it happened last year, we will move back to the online delivery. However, fingers crossed, we will be able to attend to cover all the entire course with face-to-face teaching, and we will have the opportunity to meet, and you will have the opportunity to meet and socialize. If you have any additional questions, please feel free to contact me. This is my email, and below you can see my number. Now, if you have any questions, please feel free to ask. You can just type the question in the chat box. Let me see. Okay. Hi, Stephen. If you have questions, guys, don't be worried. Ask whatever is in your mind. I believe that is an important choice that you will have to make, and it will be so it's useful to get all the information you can get from this webinar. Another information is that the induction will be while the start of the at the end of September, we will start with the face-to-face teaching according to the current government rules. There are no limitations. The induction will still be online, so you will get the link, and there will be an online session, and you will have the opportunity to get to know all our services from the library, how to use Blackboard, and all those key information. Any other question, guys? I'm sorry, I think you are not able to ask question because you are just in a participant mode. You need to type a question if you want any answer. Okay, still there. Any question, guys? Otherwise, I think that we can close the session. Okay, still on that. Okay, hi, Ryan.